Hello, this is Dario from Darustic Saltwater Adventures. Today we're going to talk about fish food. So as you see on the table, these are the types of food I give my fish, okay? So mostly I'm a big fan of a curry. So I have the mega marine algae for, what do you call it, for tangs. This one over here that I just opened is the krill. It's also a curry. Then I have the reef plankton as well, which is very, very good for small fish, and as well anthias. And then I have the rotifers as well, which I normally use to feed my corals and small fish as well. And then we have the coral gumbo from Akari as well, which I use as well to feed corals and small fish. And then we have the mega marine owl angel food for Akari. So that's, I use that for all my fish, including my tanks and everything in my tank, and they love it. Okay, and then on this side, the dry food, we have the favorite ones that they like, the flakes, the ocean nutrition. So you can see we have the ocean nutrition, and this one is the Formula One flakes, okay, which is nice. But this is their favorite over here. They love the ocean nutrition, the one that says the primary flakes. Oh my god, they can eat this all day. But it's always good to give your fish a balanced diet. Okay, what do I mean by balanced diet? That means you don't give them flake food every day. You need to alternate it with frozen food, and as well as with flake, and as well as with other food as well that I'm going to show as well. Then we have this seaweed extreme, which is very, very good for herbivores. Herbivores like tangs, and as well as other, what do you call it, other fish that love grazing on algae, like blennies as well, okay? So normally I use what, nori, but I don't know, I just prefer this, because sometimes when I put nori in my tank and then the clip comes, falls off, then the clip is lost in the tank, or some of the nori is stuck in my pump, my circulating pump. So sometimes I don't like using it, but this is easy. Switch off the canister filter, drop it in there, and then it sinks to the bottom. Now, this is the silver slide. So what do I use this one for? I used to have an eel, so I used to feed my eel this, but I noticed that you can chop this into bits, and then you can mix it with a combo and blend it and make your own frozen food or whatever food you want to mix. But what I do with this is I cut this into pieces, and then I feed them to the invertebrates like the hermit crabs, and as well as some, what do you call it, my engineer goby too loves it. Some of my tangs like it as well, you know, but I make sure I chop it into bits. You know, I thaw it first, and you know, the silver sides, make sure I thaw it first and chop it into little bits so that they can eat it. But hermit crabs, the red and the, you can see how it looks like, the red and the red-legged and the blue-legged hermit crabs and the big hermit crabs, they love it. Now we have the frozen krill. So I use this one too as well, you know, for the, what do you call it, the hermit crabs, the inverts, the red and red-legged and the blue-legged hermit crabs, they love this as well. So I do that. And then the tangs to eat it. Most of my fish, they'll eat it, you know, but engineer goby too loves this. Then I have this bad boy over here, which is, what you call it, squid. This was when I had my eel. My eel used to love this, but I don't know what I'm going to do with this. I might still keep it, or I might blend it with something else and give it to the fish. And then we have the seafood medley, okay, which has the shrimps and all that stuff and squid and everything in there. So I got this for my, it has clams as well, you can see octopus and all that stuff. Everything is over there at the top, you can see that. So I got it for my, what do you call it, for my eel that passed away. So I can still use this, blend this in my blender and make something out of it. And then I have what we call the big mysis shrimp, which they love. Okay, you can see this. So these are the variety of foods that I use to feed my fish. So I know most people normally try and blend each one of them and make their own, what do you call it, their own concoction for the fish food, which is fine. But what I normally do is I just snap this, I'll put it in a small cup, and then I'll fill it with water so I can thaw it first, and then I'll disperse it in the tank. Some people say, oh no, don't do that because when it melts, it's not good. Different strokes for different folks. I've been doing this for a while and it works. Sometimes if I'm lazy, I just put the cubes in the tank like that and it still works for me. So whatever you do is fine. You know, the most important thing is to make sure you feed your fish accordingly. And then I'll say this is just just a brief information of what I use to feed my fish, and I hope you find it interesting. I know many people are very creative about creating their own fish food, saving money, but kudos to you. So I just want to say thank you for your time. Have a good one, and then see you next time. Cheers. Bye.